Company 2, here's your radios.
When you're pulling on that trigger, is when it's going to go off.
They're going to tell the surgeon to close up, so we'll just pack you and we're going to wrap you with an ace wrap.
Then I'll probably just take
I'll take Company 1 first.
Roll them. Action!
We took a real-life situation. In this case, it was a domestic violence situation. Started here at the Homeland Security Education Center, where a husband and a wife got into a domestic altercation. It turned physical. The husband ended up shooting the wife. He was in an intoxicated state. There were two children involved. He set the apartment on fire, so he had all this going on with the people responding, the police department, the EMS students, the firefighters, all those groups were responding at the same time.
And then from the healthcare side, we had the nursing, we had respiratory, we had surgical tech, we had diagnostic imaging and nuclear med. And in addition, we also involved our theater department to help with makeup on the mannequins. And we also had our media department who filmed this all and created the edited project at the end.
One of the things that's really great for the students is that it's out of their comfort zone. Sometimes when we practice in class, we use mannequins that don't talk, they don't move. Even though we use students sometimes to serve as actors in scenarios, it's people that they know. So when it's a complete stranger as a patient, it's a lot more realistic.
I know exactly what the objectives of the scenario are and what I want the students to learn, but I also want to make it as real as possible. I want to be the most real patient that they can get, so they can practice those therapeutic communication skills.
Does it hurt?
It's not gonna hurt, but it'll be uncomfortable.
First of all, I thought it was amazing. It was probably one of the best experiences I've ever had, especially as a student. Dealing with a live patient, we definitely had to up our game with the bedside manner, because I mean, having the patient actually talk to us and having a response, it was kind of like making us think on our toes and making sure that we say the right thing.
The live patient actually brings those responses also into the classroom. And so the student has to not only take care of the physical needs, but now they also have to deal with the mental and emotional needs that that patient may have.
As a lead EMT, I was pretty much in charge of oversight of what the rest of the EMTs were doing, making sure everyone was staying on point with their specific assignment and that we were all staying within a good time frame for working on the patient, getting her on the stretcher, and getting her moved to the ambulance. I learned a lot about teamwork. I learned a lot about time management and just a lot about the stress of the situations and how to deal with that.
Pulse was 108, respirations 32, BP 90 over 54. That was when we first got on scene.
I think as an eye-opener for students, you've got to communicate, you have to be accurate, you have to work with the others and getting that message across, otherwise the patient suffers. This kind of training requires teamwork. In order to promote the teamwork, you have to have the exercise. So this is known as an interprofessional exercise, or an IPE.
It really did feel like an emergency room setting. There was a lot of chaos going on, and we had to really focus and critically think about our patient and what we needed to do, you know, to stabilize them and prepare them for where they were heading to next. Transition from the EMTs to us and to have to work with their equipment as well with our equipment.
We never correlate with the nursing students ever, and to have them here and see what we do, they gained a lot of respect for us and vice versa. The faculty is amazing, especially in the EMS department. They're there to teach you. They've been through it all. Some of them have been lieutenants on fire departments or paramedics for years, and through them we become the best that we can be.
It was very exciting overall, and I think, you know, I learned so much. I'm so happy I got to be a part of it.
I feel that I am definitely prepared for the real world. Before I came into the nursing program, I didn't think I could actually take care of a patient. But coming out of here, I actually feel a lot more confident.
My time here definitely helped me get ready for both working and for paramedic school. They had a great paramedic transition program that was just great.
We're already planning right now for next year's collaborative exercise. We want to take more of the departments and disciplines here at the college and include more departments next year, make it even bigger.
One of the things about simulation is that we don't expect the students to be perfect. We know the students are going to make mistakes. This is a classroom, and that's the wonderful thing about simulation. It's a learning moment. It's a teachable moment. We can help them to improve, and so creating these experiences allows us to broaden their knowledge base and understand how to move beyond the mistakes and to grow professionally.